Alright, so here's the fixture that I'm going to be converting. I just need to take it apart and remove the keystones here so we can convert them. I'll be cutting the ballast out. I've already cut the wires loose, so I'm taking this out, throwing it away because it's no good. Alright, now we can pull this loose. Pull this loose here. We can pull our keystones out and take them over and get them modified. Go to the shop and do that. We don't need that anymore. We get rid of that. Alright, so we're in my crowded workshop, shed, call it what you will. Anyway, I've got my drill press set up and I'm going to go ahead and do the conversion on these fluorescent tube ends. These were shunted, so I have to convert them over to non-shunted. I could just go buy some more, but the place is closed today. You know, they don't open every day of the week, and you know, for those guys of us who work Monday through Friday, we don't have the opportunity to go get these, so I'm making do with what I can. It's a simple process, and I'll show you how to convert them over. Alright, so here we have the ends from the fixture, and you'll notice that there are two holes on one side, and that's so that they can do a jump. One comes into the power, one is a jumper going to the other side, and then there's a power goes out of there, and then they're shunted because both of those metal pieces you see in there, they're connected together. And that's what provides the power to your standard fluorescent bulb. And you'll have one of these on either end. All right, here's the back. It's just got this little paper thing on the back. But what I've done is I've already went ahead and released this. And we'll take this back part off here. That'll just snap back in place. And you'll notice that here you go. You have the two clips, and there's a little piece in between. You see that little piece that's in this here. That's the shunt that makes both of these hot. So we'll just dump all this stuff out. All right, and then this little piece right here, we won't put that back in because we need the power to be separate on either side, so we'll get rid of that, and then we'll keep these pieces here. We'll put them to the side, so we keep that to the side. So what we need to do is we need to just drill a little hole here the same size as there. You know, I already got my drill press set up, so what I like to do is I like to go from the inside, that way I can get it in the correct location so it seals good. And let me loosen this up on my drill press. All right, I'm going to raise this up. To make it a little easier to deal with. Okay, let me clamp that down. Okay, set this to the side. All right, and this is going to go inside there. So let's see if I can do this without causing too much problem here. Well, I couldn't get the video on of doing the drilling, but suffice to say, there you can see there's a little hole punched in there, and that's just big enough for the wire to go in, and it will connect to the opposite side. So all we need to do at this point is to reassemble them. Now we're going to reassemble them in the reverse order. We'll have our, there we go. We have our piece here. We'll take our connectors. You'll notice there's a left and a right. We'll put one on either side. Okay, notice we're not putting the shunt back in. And then we'll take this piece. And it's just going to go right over top of there. Well, there it is. It's all back together. And what will happen is we'll just run one wire on this side and one wire on that side. And this will make our lamps work. Okay, and there we have all the eight keystones all put back together. Like I said, it's a very simple process. Just drilling this other hole in and taking out the shunt. And got a little extra parts in there that we don't need. So, now to be fair, on a regular light fixture, you only need one of these for an LED bulb. You don't need two keystones set up. A lot of times you just clip the wires on the opposite end and it doesn't make any difference. But I went ahead and did these because I've got a few more fixtures that I'm going to be converting over and may as well do it while I've got it set up here. Alright, now we got our modified keystones here. There's a little hole there. We'll take and put this thing back together without all of our wires. These to just snap back into place. It's noisy out here. All the vehicles and traffic and pressure washer across the street. I guess it's a fine day for people to be working outside. It's not too hot, not too cold. All right, we got the keystones in. I already put them in this side, so we're just about ready. You notice that there's absolutely nothing in here now. We'll have to wire these up in just a minute, but now we'll go ahead and reverse install this in reverse order. We'll get the end on and we'll put these screws back in these little holes here. All right, it's all assembled. We just have to wire it up now. Haven't chosen which side I'm going to be doing the power on, but I will just choose this side, why not? Alright, so let me get this thing wired up. Alright, we've got our wires here. You know, it's a simple proposition. There's the holes there. We just slide it in, makes contact. We'll do. Before we put our holes. See my hole? There we go. Here. One. Now we have these. All we have to do is hook these up to our power now. Show you a neat little trick. Keep your wires a little neater. Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to take this drill, cordless drill, we're going to take the ends of the wire here that are cut the same length. We're just going to loosen this up a little bit. We're not going to turn it real fast. We're going to go ahead and tighten it down a little bit. And then we'll just let this turn. And it'll twist all the wires together. And we'll release it. And you have a nice little bundle here. We'll do that for the others as well. Thank you.
now you can see we have nice little bundles coming off of there. We'll just trim these back and be a nice finish. We won't have a lot of chance for things to get caught and maybe pinched and shorted out. All right, we've got it mounted up on the ceiling here. And all we do now is just to connect the wiring to it.